some hip flexor stretching, and we're trying to protect your back while we're doing that. This is my favorite way of accomplishing this. So when I have you lay down on this table, I want your hip right here to line up with this line, okay? And your other foot's going to be as far forward as we can get it, and that'll protect the back. So you're going to be like this. This foot's going to be far forward. You can kind of just rest your forehead there. And then once you get into this position, I am going to elevate this slightly until you feel a little stretch, and then I'm going to add a little bit of a knee bend to get even more of a stretch. Let me lower this just a tad here, since I'm so much taller than you are. I don't get to say that too often, that was a joke. Okay, so on your stomach. You got it? You got it? Good. And you remembered that foot. Good. Most people are not as smart as Tina. They're not going to remember that foot, but and you might have to even help them with that a little bit. No, you're actually, yeah, you're really good there. So we're in a good position. Does your back feel pretty good there?
Yes.
Sometimes you have to raise or lower the table a little bit. Even lowering the table, I'm just going to lower that table just a little bit. By the way, lowering the table a little bit will even create more lumbar flexion, which is what we're kind of trying to implement here. How does that feel?
Good.
Good? By the way, I just adjusted that with her on the table. Not the safest way to do it, so be careful with that. That might not be the best idea to copy. Now from here, I'm just gonna raise this. You tell me when you feel a little stretch. There, can we go further without pain?
Yeah.
Good. And where do you feel that stretch?
In the front.
Front of the hip. That's what we were hoping to hear. You don't want to say, does that hurt? Because yeah, stretching does hurt a little bit. Is where I do not want Tina to feel this is her low back. We do not want that. If she's feeling it in the low back, we've done something wrong. We're overarching. So now that you're feeling that stretch there, we're just gonna add a little bit of knee bending to that. So go ahead and relax here. You feel that intensify a little bit?
Yes.
Good. So we're gonna hold that. And you know, might hold that for 20 seconds. And then I'm gonna drop you down out of that. And then I'm gonna walk over here and just let you know that I'm not stretching you right now. We're letting you recover from that a little bit. And then I could come back and we can do that intermittently, because what happens when I bend your knee like this? What do you feel is happening when I do this?
I feel more of a pull in the front part of the hip.
Yeah. And do you feel it up near your hip or down towards your knee?
I feel it mostly up near my hip. And a little bit in the front of the leg.
Perfect. So that is the hip flexor stretch. Definitely my favorite way to stretch hip flexors. There's ways that patients can do this at home by getting into a staggered stance, you know, posture, tilting their pelvis, and then stretching forward, stretching away, doing that even on one knee, that type of thing. So certainly you would want to teach your patient to do those things, but they would have a hard time doing this at home because they don't have tables that tilt like this. And you do need a tilting table that will, with a segment that elevates from this hinge like this, because